feeling. Oh, no, please, don't be alarmed. You may not recognize me, but I'd hope that maybe my presence might feel familiar to you somehow. It's all right. You see, I am your guardian angel. I know, it sounds silly, doesn't it? Well, truth be told, I am not your personal guardian angel. You are but one of quite a few humans I watch over. But I have to say, between you and me, you're one of my favorites. That's a secret. So, it made me quite upset when I sensed you were going through a hard time, feeling low, and I wanted to come and check up on you. And when I saw you in person and felt up close just how distressed you were, I decided that I would reveal myself to you. Special measures, you might say. When you wake up, this will all be a dream. So, let's enjoy this time together, shall we? So, you don't have to tell me what's troubling you if you don't want to. I understand. I'm not telepathic, you see. I just, I feel your emotions. I can sense them. I can feel when you're tense or worried. And I have some limited ability to heal and send comforting waves in order to make you feel better. But while I'm an angel, I'm somewhat of a lesser angel, truth be told. As guardian angels, we don't truly have too much power. We're low on the food chain, you might say. But that's alright. I wouldn't have it any other way. I love my job. That being said, I think you require a little bit more than just my typical waves. I can see that while they might help you in the moment, they're not really making a dent into those worried feelings buried deep in your mind. You must have something that is really bothering you and clinging on. But I do have a solution. You see, for circumstances just like these, we carry around a feather from a higher angel's wing. Just one is all that's needed. As you can see, the power gap is quite substantial. But this holds a lot of magic, you may say. Ability to cleanse your mind. Dust away the cobwebs, you might say. Don't worry, we won't be erasing anything. I'm not here to wipe your memory or take away anything that might be important to you. All that we're doing is scrubbing off the negative emotions that might be associated. Does that make sense? So, while you'll still be able to recall these troublesome memories or these you feel uncomfortable, but I really do think it could help you and calm your sleep. Oh, I saw you when I first came in, tossing and turning. It seems you haven't had a decent night's sleep. And what is it now? Weeks? Months? I know it's not your fault, but it's not good for you. I'm hoping that by coming in today, you might be able to reset your mind. So, what do you think? Shall we use this? If you'd prefer, I could always use my more traditional methods. Provide some temporary relief. Effective, if short, but perhaps I can stay with you and ensure that your mind is at rest tonight. I'm happy to hear that. Yes, it is a shame I can't do this myself, but as long as I have the ability, that's all. Might feel a little tickly at first. We are going all the way in to your thoughts. Getting rid of anything that might be troubling you. See whether it's a change in your life, a new house you're moving to, a new job, new friends, adjustments. That can always be hard and scary. Certainly a very common cause of anxiety and restlessness. But you'll always make it through in the end and settle as if that's how it's always been. You just need to be patient. Perhaps you're caught up in worrying about the past. The future. It can be very easy to do, but you have to remember that what's most important is now, and what you can do in your present. There's no way to change the past, and planning for the future is good. You're worrying about things you can't yet possibly know. Well, that just isn't fair on you. Or maybe it's judgment from other humans. People treating you unfairly. That can always be difficult to deal with. I know. You have to remember that the only people that matter are those you truly care about and who care about and respect you and will support you. If it helps, I will support you no matter what. you ever need me to come along and let you know that you're worth it, I'll just come back. I think we're starting to look a little bit cleaner up in here. How are you feeling? Any improvement is good. But I think we can make you feel much better before I'm done. Understandable. It can always be difficult. Hopefully, when it's done, you can relax. You certainly will have earned it. But in the meantime, you need to remember to look after yourself in the ways that matter. Keep up the basics. Take breaks. And do the best that you troubling you so. I hope you can take a little solace in the fact that right now, in this moment, it's all about you. And you are safe and secure here with me. And I brief moment. You can relax and try to fall asleep and get the rest that your body deserves. It's always cliche, I know. The little things can make such a difference. Making sure that you sleep and eat and take care of yourself on the most basic level. It can be difficult sometimes, but it does make a difference. Feeling. You know, even without the magical powers, the feather has quite a therapeutic effect just from the feeling, doesn't it? Right. Well, with all of that energy, I'm going to just blow it away. and advice if you'd like, then feel free if it would make you feel better. Do you mind if I play with your hair? Feel free to talk to me as I do. I can give you a scalp massage if you'd like. I see. That is difficult. But I think, from what I've seen, you seem like a remarkably strong person. And you may not agree with me. I think everybody underestimates themselves. And you have the potential. Helping. I always like a scalp massage or a halo massage. I suppose you don't have those. It's quite like a scalp massage, really. Let me put that hair back into place. There we go. So, I hope you feel better than when I came in, and that I was able to be of some assistance. I am committed. My duty of being your guardian angel. And in fact, if you should ever need me again, and I'm not appearing, which I will make it my priority to do so, if I sense that you are feeling low again, I can give something precious. I will leave this behind. And if you wish to speak to me in your dreams again, all you need to do is slip it under your pillow when you go to sleep. Right? That way I'll be able to sense that you'd like to see me. And are perhaps in need of comforting or clearing out your mind again. But for now, I must say goodbye. While I admitted some favoritism, I do have other people to see and attend to. I'm very glad I got to see you. Well, I hope you won't have need of me again for a while. I do very much look forward to seeing you.